教的背景，那我一直对天主教基督教搞不清楚，有一些结在里面，他就 很快速地帮助我把它解开了。
And what I think Chris does so well is communicate with clarity and also with love and authority too.
Chris 在沟通的时候呢，非常的清晰，非常的有权柄，而非常充满了爱心。
So I know tonight as we hear our first session that we'll all be very blessed. So let's welcome him.
那今天晚上呢，我们会非常的隆重的欢迎。
It's a pleasure to be here.Thank you very much for having me.
谢谢大家可以接纳我在这里。
I really do look forward to serving with you guys this week.
我很期待跟大家在一起在这边服侍。
And I hope that myself and my team can be a blessing to you.
我们希望我们的团队会是一个祝福。那我们先欢迎我们的翻译器在我们中间。
I want to start today.
我今天想要开始。
By looking at a story that's very familiar to us all.
来看这个对我们来一个很熟悉的故事。
The woman with the well.
这个在水井旁边的女人。
But to set the stage, to begin.
但是我们一开始的时候。
Everyone turn to Isaiah 32:2.
请大家来读我们的经节以赛亚书的32章的第二节。
So again, that was Isaiah 32.
以赛亚书三十二章。
Two.
二节。
Each one will be like a shelter from the wind and a refuge from the storm, like streams of water in the desert and a shadow of a great rock in a thirsty land.
三十二章二节的经节讲到，必有一人像避风所或避暴雨的隐秘处，又像河流在干旱之地，像大磐石的影子在疲乏之地。
What I hope we see after this intro talk.
我希望在我们今天这个演讲之后
，is that each one of you.
希望你们每一个人
，everyone.
每一个人
is called to be.A well from which the living water of our God flows. So no matter where you are, no matter what your situation, no matter how you feel, you will know.
都会知道
that our Lord is with you,
我们的神与你同在的
and that His power flows through you.
他的能力能够流过。
Amen. All right, John 4. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. John 4.
约翰福音第四章。
We'll start with verses 4-8.
从第四到第八节。
Now he had to go through Samaria. So he came to a town in Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of ground Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired as he was from the journey, sat down by the well.It was about noon. When a Samaritan woman came to draw water, Jesus said to her, Will you give me a drink? His disciples had gone into town to buy food.
在约翰福音第四章第四到八节的部分是，我们提到必须经过撒玛利亚，于是到了撒玛利亚的一座城叫做叙加，靠近雅各给他儿子约瑟的那块地。在那里有雅各井，耶稣因走路困乏，就坐在井旁。那时约有五阵，有一个撒玛利亚的妇人来打水。耶稣对他说：“请你给我水喝。”那时门徒进城， 把食物去了。
Now for some background on the story.
所以在这个故事的背景。
The issue between the Samaritans and the Jews.
在这个撒玛利亚人跟犹太人的这样中间的关系中。
Concerned where do we worship God?
我们提到我们要在哪边敬拜神。
It was tied to a place.
它是锁定一个地方的。
And the Jews knew
犹太人知道
there was only one place
只有一个地方
to worship God
来敬拜神
at the temple
就是在
in Jerusalem
就是他当初的敬拜所
but the Samaritans
但是撒玛利亚人
had split from the Jews
已经跟犹太人分开了
and said we will worship
他会说我们要来敬拜
at Mount Gerizim
在另外一个地方
Now the reason why
这个原因是
worship of God
敬拜神
at one place was important
在那个地方是很重要的
was because God
因为神
was one
只有一个
He was not split
他并不会
His attributes were not divided
他并不会被分开
He was one
他就是那唯一的
And so the Jews
所以犹太人
had rejected the Samaritans.
就拒绝了这些撒玛利亚人
They had said go.
就把他们送走了
They would have nothing to do with them.
他们不想跟他们任何关系
And so Jesus found himself alone.
所以耶稣发现他自己一个人
at this well
在这个水井
of the Samaritans.
在这个撒玛利亚的地方
because his disciples.
就是因为他的门徒们
would have nothing to do with them.
都不想跟这些撒玛利亚人在一起。
And into this moment,
所以在这个时候
comes a woman,
这个妇人
so broken,
是非常破碎的妇人
so full of hurt,
里面非常的破碎
that she could not show her face,
她没有办法把她的脸显示出来
around others,
在其他人面前。
Because they rejected her
因为她被拒绝
for her past
因为她的过去
and for her sin
因为她的罪
This is a woman
这就是这个妇人
for whom Jesus came to meet
就是耶稣要来跟她遇见的
Let's continue
让我们继续
John 4:16-184:9 The Samaritan woman said to him, You are a Jew, and I am a Samaritan woman. How can you ask me for a drink?
耶稣说，你去叫你的丈夫也到这里来。妇人说，我没有丈夫。
Sorry,
is it
first time?
Okay.
Yeah.
撒玛利亚的妇人对他说：“你既是犹太人，怎么向我一个撒玛利亚妇人要水喝呢？”原来犹太人和撒玛利亚人没有来往。
Now, what's fascinating about this?
那这个故事精彩的地方
is that Jesus originally asked her.
是耶稣先来开口跟他要求的。
He had no bucket.
他就是没有任何的水桶。
To draw from the well.
从水里面取水。
And so here he asks her.
所以耶稣就来问他了。
Who has a bucket?
谁会有这个水桶呢？
But no living water.
但是却没有活水。
She wasn't going to Jerusalem.
这位妇人并没有去耶路撒冷。
And yet Jesus still said.
但是耶稣依然说了。
Give me water to drink.
给我水喝吧。
Because he knew.
因为他知道。
Prophetically.
先知性的知道。
That this woman.
这位妇人。
And all her brokenness.
在她的破碎里面。
With all her unworthiness.
所有就是感觉没有价值的地方。
Was about to become a well.
都要变成一个水井。
Full of the living water of God.
充满了活水。
Who could give someone else? Something to drink.
甚至可以有流出来跟别人分享。
So she had an encounter with Jesus.
所以她就遇见了耶稣。
She not only went to the well of salvation,
她不止进入了一个救赎的井,
but she became a well
她也成为了一个水井,
that was able to pour out to others.
能够把这个水取出来, 来供给别人。
Let's continue.
让我们继续。
John 4:10-15.
约翰福音第四章。十到十五节。
Jesus answered her, if you knew the gift of God and who it is that asks you for a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water. Sir, the woman said, you have nothing to draw with and the well is deep.Where can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well and drank from it himself? Are you, as did also the sons and his flocks and herds? Jesus answered, everyone, and pay very close attention, everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks the water I give him will never thirst. How many in here have had dry spells? I've had dry spells. But apparently, oh sure, go ahead.
让我把这个听清。约翰福音第四章十到十五节，耶稣回答说：“你若知道神的恩赐和对你说给我水喝的是谁，你必早求他，他也必早给了你活水。”妇人说：“先生啊，没有打水的器具，井又深，你从哪里得活水呢？我们的祖宗雅各将这井留给我们，他自己和儿子并畜生也都喝这井里的水，难道你比他还大吗？”耶稣回答说：“凡喝这水的还要再渴，人若喝我所赐的水，就永远不渴。我所赐的水也要在他里面成为泉源，直涌到永生。”妇人说：“先生啊，请把这水赐给我，叫我不渴，也不用再这么远来打水。”
So I ask him, who in here has had a dry spell?
在这里当这个现场的弟兄姐妹，有没有觉得有干枯的地方？
Scripture has an answer.
我们的经节有个答案。
If you are truly saved of Christ,
如果你真的透过基督得救的话。
Then you are a well.
你就是个水井。
The only question is,
那唯一的问题就是,
do you have the water of life running through you?
你在里面当中有真的有活水在里面涌流吗?
To find out how we get this water,
要找出来我们要如何取得这个活水。
Let's read further.
我们必须要继续读下去。
But now the woman said,the woman said, Sir, if you've already read, that's okay. Give me this water so that I won't get thirsty and have to keep coming here to draw water.
妇人说，先生啊，请把这水赐给我，叫我不渴，也不用来这里面打水。
As I said, you became a well the moment you accepted Christ.
就像我说的，在你接受耶稣基督成为救主的时候，你也成为这个水井。
You are a new creation.
你是个新的受造物。
Do not listen to anything telling you you are still as broken as you were.
不要去听从任何其他的声音说你还是一样的破碎。
It's not true.
那不是真的。
However, to see it.
但是能够看得到
to see who God has made you to be,
要看到你神是当创造你是什么样的人
to see the power of God move through you,
要看到神的大能从你身上展现出来
we have to correct one thing,
我们必须要纠正一件事情
we can't keep going to the old places of worship,
我们再也不能去那个老旧的那个敬拜的地方
We can't go to our jobs.
我们不能去我们的工作。
We can't go to our money.
我们不能去我们的金钱。
We can't go to our homes.
我们不能在家里面。
For security.
来找到安全感。
We can't go to our knowledge.
我们不能透过知识。
For security.
来找安全感。
We have to figure out.
我们必须要搞清楚。
What is this New Jerusalem?
我们的新耶路撒冷在哪里？
Where we can go.
我们是可以去那个地方。
To worship in spirit and truth.
来真正的敬拜你，跟真理。
And now we read on to find out what this is.
那接下来我们继续读。
This is John 4:19 through 24. Sir, the woman said, I can see that you are a prophet. Our fathers worshipped on the mountain. But you Jews, you claim that there is a place where we must worship is in Jerusalem. Jesus declared, Believe me, woman, a time is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You Samaritans worship what you do not know. We worship what we do know. For salvation is from the Jews. Yet a time is coming and has now come when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. For they are the kind of worshipers the Father seeks. God is spirit, and his worshipers must worship in spirit and truth.
妇人说：“先生，我看出你是先知。我们的祖宗在这山上礼拜，你们倒说，应当礼拜的地方是在耶路撒冷。”耶稣说：“妇人，你当信我，时候将到，你们拜父也不在这山上，也不在耶路撒冷。你们所拜的，你们不知道；我们所拜的，我们知道，因为救恩是从犹太人出来的。时候将到，如今就是了。”那真正拜父的，要用心灵和诚实来拜他，因为父要这样的人拜他。神是个灵，所以拜他的必须用心灵和诚实拜他。
No longer is God limited to a single temple.
所以我们的神再也不会被局限在一个敬拜的殿堂。
And yet somehow he remains one.
但是他还是维持。
Somehow we can now worship him anywhere.
现在我们可以随时在什么地方敬拜他。
Because God no longer resides in an earthly temple.
因为神不再居住在那个地上的那个殿堂。
You go to the same temple wherever you go.
你可以在你所到之处的任何地方敬拜他。
In fact, you bring this with you wherever you go.
你甚至可以带着这个同在者到处旅行。
What is a well?
那这个水井是什么呢？
It's something that holds water.
是把这个水凝住的地方。
In ancient times, what was the temple?
在古代的时候，有个水井是什么？
Something that God dwelled in.
那就是神所居住的地方。
When Jesus tore the veil.
当耶稣走向那水井的时候
，He made it so that we became the temple of the Holy Spirit.
他就等于为我们设预备道路，让我们可以变成圣灵的殿堂。
We can worship God anywhere.
我们可以在任何地方敬拜他。
In the most fruitful of lands.
可以在最有结果实的地方。
And in the driest desert.
也可以在很干旱的地方。
We can be wells.
我们可以成为水井
，where the Spirit of God overflows，
只要就圣灵透过我们的力量流出来
，floods the plain，
甚至可以涌流在整个地方
，with streams of living water，
透过这个活水的江流。
What does this look like？
这个看起来像什么呢
？One，
一个
，setting the captives free，
将被掳的释放
，freedom from sin。
从罪里面得到释放。
We can proclaim this.
我们可以宣告。
Freedom from sickness.
从疾病里面得释放。
We can pray this into people and see healing come.
我们可以在人面前祷告，然后看到医治来到。
Freedom from oppression.
在压制里面得释放。
we no longer have to live ourselves under oppression, and we can proclaim freedom to those who are oppressed.
我们完全不用再被受到任何辖制，甚至我们可以向那些受辖制的人来做宣告。
And all we have to do.
那我所需要做的只是
to fill that well up.
把那个水井给灌
满。Have it overflow.
然后那个涌流出来。
Is worship God.
就是敬拜上帝。
That's it.
就这样。
When reading your Bible.
当你读经节的时候。
You worship God.
你敬拜神。
When you pray.
当你祷告。
You worship God.
你敬拜神。
When you work,
当你工作的时候,
you worship God.
你敬拜神。
When you eat,
当你吃饭,
you worship God.
你敬拜神。
When you speak,
当你讲的时候,
you worship God.
你敬拜神。
And the water will continuously flow through you every single day.
那个活水就可以透过你涌流出来在每一天的生活当中。
This took me years to understand.
这件事情其实我花了很多年才了解。
But when I realized,
当我了解的时候
，that God was in me,
神在我里面
，empower,
在里面强壮我。
Like it says in Acts 1:8, Acts 1:8,
在《使徒行传》的第一章第八节
，that the Spirit was in me,
灵在我里面
，so that I could be a witness,
所以我可以成为一个很好的见证人。
I realized.
我理解到,
this isn't in special moments.
这不是只是, 特殊的时候,
this is for every moment.
这其实每个时候都是这样的。
This is for our businesses.
这是为我们的事业。
This is for our schools.
为我们的学业。
The power of God.
上帝的大能。
And His kingdom.
还有他的国王国。
Coming to earth.
就要来降到地上。
We're breaking in.
要来破碎任何的。
And saying the enemy.Saying to the enemy,
甚至对时间来宣告
It's time to go.
你要走了
Praise God.
感谢神
And here's my question.
所以这就是我现在的一个问题
If you are a well,
如果你是那水井
and you would like to be filled with God, not just now, but always.
你希望 是不是不只是现在被这活水充满，而且是永远的
I want you to pair up with somebody.
我希望你找到一个 partner.
Surrender to God.
然后把自己完全交给神。
And simply say, God, I'm here to worship you.
跟神说神啊，我在这里就是来敬拜你。
All of my days.
我所有的时间。
Let me be. Let me be.
让我成为。
A well of living water.
那个活水的水井。
For your name's sake.
因为你的名。
So go ahead and do this now. I'm going to come around and pray for people as well.But if that's what you want,
现在请你找一个 partner 开始开始练习。
Go ahead and pair up, and we'll do this for maybe 10 minutes.
就是一组一组两个人，那当然牧师后来会给我祷告。
And then we'll start part two.
然后我们就下一个。
But I want to now talk about.
但是我现在想要来讲一些
how to receive from the Spirit.
如何从圣灵当中来领受
？In order for us to receive from God，
那为了能够从神那里领受
，during our moments of worship，
在我们敬拜的时候
，prayer，
在祷告的时候
，impartation，
在更高传递的时候
，and ministry，
在服事的时候
，we have to be open to receive。
我们必须要能够很开放的来接受。
Mary and Martha are a great example。
玛利亚跟玛莎是很好的一个范一个案例。
When Jesus visited them,
当耶稣拜访他们的时候
，One did what she thought was her duty.
其中一个在觉得他在做他该做的事情
，And so couldn't hear from God.
所以没有办法听到神的声音。
The other,
另外一个呢
，Sat at Jesus' feet.
就坐在耶稣的脚前。
Now this was no simple sitting down and listen.
那也不是很简单的坐下来听听而已。
To sit at the feet of a rabbi，
他在坐在一个拉比的脚前。
Was to be a disciple，
其实是象征了来当他的门徒。
Her heart posture，
他的心。
Was that of humility，
是放在一个谦卑的态度上。
So let's read James 4，
让我们来读雅各书第四章
6-7。
第六跟第七节。
Father, glorify your name. Oh, sorry, whoops, wrong verse. But he gives more grace. Therefore, it says, God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you.
所以，但他赐更多的恩典，所以经上说，神阻挡骄傲的人，赐恩给谦卑的人。故此，你们要顺服神，勿要抵挡魔鬼，魔鬼就必离开你们逃跑。
The only way，
唯一的方式
，we can receive from God，
我们能够从神那边领受
，through a humble posture，
是透过一个谦卑的态度。
We have to sit at His feet。
我们必须要坐在他的脚前
，and receive，
来领受。
And sometimes，
有的时候
，that takes many forms。
会有不同的形式。
I can tell a story.
Would you like me to tell you a funny story?
你要听一个有趣的故事。
Funny story about humility. Here we go.
一个关于谦卑的有趣的故事。
I had a really hard day.
我有一天是很多工作上的挑战。
I worked at a hospital.
我那天在医院工作。
And the doctor had to give someone bad news.
医生必须要带一些坏消息。
And so it was just a very long day.
所以那一天对我来说非常久长。
So my friend invited me to a baseball game.
所以有一个朋友邀请我去一个棒球赛。
And we sat in the home run area.
我们就坐在那个球场。
本垒。And he said, "Wouldn't it be funny if you caught a ball?"
那如果现在如果能够接到个球，不就非常有趣了吗
？So they hit a home run.
结果他们的确打了一个 home run， 一个全垒打。
And I got the ball.
然后我拿到球。
But guess what?
那你猜猜呢
？I waited to pick up this ball for about a minute and a half.
我大概等了1.5分，1分半钟才去把那个球捡起来。
No one came.
没有人来。
So I said, "Okay, I'll take it."
Oh, okay. 那我就没有人来，我就拿了。
Now maybe at that point.When I was just about ready to go and sit down.
那在那个我可能准备要去坐那个坐下去的时间里
，all the way across the field.
在那个球场的另外一边
，these two little kids started running.
有两个小孩子开始在跑过来
，and I was confused.
那我就觉得很疑惑
，because in the north,
因为在北方
，whoever gets the ball keeps it.
谁能捡到球就留着啦。
So these two kids ran over.
所以这两个小朋友就跑过来
，and they asked me for the ball.
他们要把球给他们。
And I like a good pastor.
那我是一个。
Of course not. So here's what happened. 20,000 people started to boo.
所以20,000人开始 boo.
20,000.
20,000人开始在嘘。
Stadium.
那整个球场。
I had had a bad day, y'all.
我那天已经很糟糕了。
Now I'm getting booed by 20,000 people.
我现在被20,000人嘘。
So I handed them the ball. I said, "Okay, God."
所以我就把那个球拿出来。
Handed them the ball. I said, "Enjoy the ball."
就给那两个小朋友，你说你们享受吗
？Moment of weakness, but I recovered.
那个时候他觉得很软弱，不过后来恢复了。
And then the kid said this.
那小朋友就说了。
Now I have 7.
我现在有七个球了。
And the other kid said, "I've only got 6. That's not fair."
另外小朋友说，我就拿六个，不公平啊。
I said, "I've had any."
我没有。
So here's the thing. So that was a rough day.
所以那天真的是很冗长的、很累的一天。
But.
但是呢。
I said, "You know, God."
你知道神吗？神。
I'm glad those kids could get blessed.
我很高兴那些小朋友能受到祝福。
I told the story.
那我就分享这个故事。
Here's where it comes into play with this.
那就跟这个有点关系。
To my eighth grade class. I taught eighth grade. I'm 13-year-olds.
所以我教八年级13岁的这些学生。
You know, just as a funny story.
只是一些有趣的故事。
And one of them came in the next day.
那其中一个人第二天过来。
And had a glass encased home run ball he gave me.
然后有一个，在一个这个瓶子里，一个容器里面有八个这个全垒打的球。
In that moment,
在那个时候
，God showed me，
神就让我显示
，that gifts，
那个礼物
，can come from anywhere，
可以从任何地方来
，even kids that you don't necessarily think care about you，
就算是那些觉得你他不太在乎你的那些小朋友
，is there an eighth grade？
因为他们可能只有八年级
，and here love came out of a place least expected，
那他也是可以把这个祝福传给你。
So I just want to kind of let you know the humility。
所以我是要开始要讲这些关于谦卑的词。
When we accept it, we sit in a place where we can receive, right, from anybody, whoever God has us receive from。
当我们坐在那个位置是可以领受的位置的时候
，It's vital that we remain open. We remain open.
那我们必须要能够那个时候很重要的是我们要能够保持开放的态度。
Now the second one。
第二个
is repentance。
就是要能够认罪。
James 1:21。
雅各书第一章二十一节。
Therefore, put away all filthiness and rampant wickedness, and receive with meekness the implanted word, which is able to save your souls.
雅各书一章二十一节，所以你们要脱去一切的污秽和盈余的邪恶，存温柔的心，领受那所栽种的道。就是能救你们灵魂的道。
This is not saying，
这个部分不是在讲。
You have to be perfect，
你一定要完美。
To approach and receive from God，
才能够接近，然后从神那边领受。
This is saying，
他其实这个部分在说。
When God has something for you，
当神要有给你一些东西的时候。
It often calls you to repent，
他通常会呼召你要先认罪。
And so we have to be in a position。
所以我们必须要在一个位置
to walk in repentance，
是要准备能够走进认罪。
I gave the ball back，
所以我把球又还给他们。
I repented，
我认罪。
We also have to trust God，
我们也必须要能够信靠神。
And this is very hard，
这是非常困难的。
For people like myself，
像我自己
，who are used to fending for ourselves，
很习惯要保护自己。
For doing everything for ourselves，
做每件事都为了自己。
Who have never had people watching out for you，
那没有人在背后看守着你。
But here's how good our God is，
但是这里就是我们神很棒的地方。
That we should trust Him，
我们应该要信靠他。
James 1，
雅各书第一章
16-17，
16-17节。
Do not be deceived。My fellow brothers, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change.
我亲爱的弟兄们，不要看错了，各样美善的恩赐和各样全备的赏赐，都是从上头来的，从众光之父那里降下来的，在他并没有改变。也没有转动的影儿。
If you've ever been afraid，
如果你曾经害怕
，that you can't hear from God，
你没有办法听到神
，or that God doesn't speak to you，
或是你觉得神根本就不对你说话
，that verse says otherwise。
那个经节是在讲另外一个故事。
God wants to give you good gifts，
神要给你好的礼物。
He wants to speak to you，
他想要对你说话。
He is speaking to you，
他现在正在对你说话。
But we have to trust Him，
但我们必须要信靠他。
And in that trust，
在那个信心里面
，ask Him，
再来询问他。
What He has prompted us in our hearts，
他放在我们心里面去
ask，
来我们去问他。
James 1:6-7，
雅各书第一章六到七节。
But let him ask in faith， with no doubting。For the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea that is driven and tossed by the wind. For that person must not suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord.
只要凭着信心求，一点不疑惑，因为那疑惑的人就像海中的波浪，被风吹动翻腾。这样的人不要想从主那里得到什么。
But how do you ask without doubting?
那你要怎么在没有疑惑的状况之下来询问神呢？
How do you believe without doubting?
那你要怎么在不疑惑中来信靠呢？
It may seem impossible.
也许这个是看起来很不可能的事情。
Because for us it is.
因为对我们从我们角度来讲，是真的是看起来不可能。
We can't make faith.
我们没有办法来制造自己的信心。
It's a gift from God.
这个信心是从神来的礼物。
When I pray for people to be healed.
当我为人祷告医治的时候
，I'm not mustering up some belief.
我是必须要里面的属于一些不信的部分。
I ask God for faith to believe.
我跟神要信心来相信。
And my doubt is eradicated.
那我的疑惑就除去掉。
Not by me.
不是因为我。
Tonight.
今天晚上。
We're going to pray for people's healing.
我们今天要为医治来祷告。
We're all going to do it.
我们大家都要来操练。
We're going to pray for forgiveness.
我们要来祷告饶恕。
All going to do it.
都一起来做
Because God called all of us
因为上帝呼召了我们全部的人
to believe
来相信
that the kingdom
神的国
has come
已经来到地上
Praise God
赞美主
Finally
最后
It's important
非常重要的
to yield to God
来依靠神
which doesn't mean you're not a robot
这不是意思不是指你是机器人
But you're walking with him
但是是你意思是你跟他一起走
We also need to relax
我们必须要也能够放松
Sometimes when we pray
当我们祷告的时候
We're about to ask for something really big
尤其是我们要问跟神求很大的事情的时候
We get nervous
我们会紧张
But we can just take a step back
那我们可以倒退一步
Take a breath
就深吸一口气。
Just say, "Okay, God, I need you to help me believe."
就告诉神说，神啊，我必须要你请你帮助我相信。
And then go and pray in power.
然后就进入有能力的祷告。
And finally,
最后
we need to be sensitive.
我们必须要敏感。
Because as it says,
因为这里说
in Isaiah 26:3,
以赛亚书26:3,
you keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you.Because he trusts you.
精心依靠你的，你必保守他十分平安，因为他依靠你。
How I hear from God?
我要如何听到神的声音
？It's because my mind is on him.
是因为我的心固定在他的身上。
Both through scripture.
从经节来。
And in submission to him.
也对着顺，也是在顺服而来。
And in prayer to him.
然后在我的祷告的，对他祷告当中。
And in humility.
这是在谦卑里面。
So tonight as we pray,
所以今天晚上我们祷告的时候
I want you to remember these things.
我希望你们能记得这些事情。
First,
第一个
that you are a well,
你是一个水井
flowing to overflowing,
要拿这个涌流出来
with living water,
这个活水能够涌流出来。
And two,
第二点
in humility,
在谦卑当中
repentance,
来认罪
trust
信靠
asking
需求
yielding
依靠
and sensitivity
然后敏感
we can approach God
我们可以向追求神
hear from his spirit
听到他的声音
and proclaim as Jesus did
并且宣告
the kingdom is at hand
神的国在这里降临
and so I want to take another moment
所以我们接下来要花点时间
5 minutes
大概5分钟
I just want everybody to close their eyes.
大家来闭上眼睛
And go ahead and pray.
来开始祷告
For the following.
来根据下面的那个
First.
第一个
That the Spirit of God
让神的灵
would be with you.
来跟我们在一起
That you would be convinced
让你会被说服
of his presence.
他的同在
That he has not left you alone.
他并没有离开你
And he is with you even now.
他现在就陪伴着你。
No matter how dry you may feel,
不管你有多觉得有多干，不管你什么样的感觉。
And I'm going to come around and continue to pray with people, but it'll be quiet.
那我们现在就会来为大家祷告，在安静当中为大家祷告。
We'll take maybe 5 to 7 minutes.
大概会做这样5到7分钟。
Okay. How are you guys doing? Feeling pretty good?So for the last part,
so 在最后的时候
I want to talk about your authority.
然后我们来讨论一下你的权柄。
In Christ.
在基督里面。
So the believer's authority.
你信徒的权柄。
Is to partner with the Holy Spirit.
是跟圣灵来搭档。
To make real and tangible.
来制造真实并且很具体的。
The victory that Christ achieved.
基督所达到的胜利。
Through his death and resurrection.
透过他的死亡跟他的复活。
This is vital.
这个是非常重要的。
As Christians.
当一个基督徒。
We are called.
我们被呼召。
By Jesus.
被耶稣来呼召。
To walk out the Great Commission.
去走出大使命。
And to continue the work he came here.The ministry he came here doing.
来继续他当初在地球上所做的事工。
And he gave us authority.
他给我们权柄。
In his name.
透过他的名。
To do just that.
来做这件事。
We're going to go ahead and read.
我们接下来继续读。
Matthew 28.
马太福音二十八章。
18 through 20.
好，十八到二十节。
And Jesus came and said to them, All authority.All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore. So again, here's the authority.
18-20.
He said, Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you.And behold, I am with you always to the end of the age.
所以第十八节，耶稣近前来对他们说：“天上地下所有的权柄都赐给我了，所以你们要去，使万民做我的门徒，奉父子圣灵的名给他们施洗，凡我所吩咐你们的，都教训他们遵守。我就常与你们同在，直到世界的末了。”
So based on the authority of Jesus.
所以根据耶稣的权柄。
We can go and make disciples.
所以我们可以出去来做主的门徒。
You have a divine right.
因为你你现在有属灵的权利。
To share about Jesus with others.
来跟其他人分享耶稣。
No one can tell you it's illegal.
没有人可以告诉你这是非法的。
No one can tell you, oh, I'm sorry, you can't tell someone about God.
没有人可以说哦，不行，你不能告诉别人关于神的事情。
He's given you the authority.
他已经给了你权柄。
I want you to hear this. Paul went to jail.
我要告诉你保罗进了监牢。
For sharing the gospel.
因为他分享福音。
People have lost jobs.
有些人因为这样失去了工作。
For sharing the gospel.
因为分享福音。
You know what?
你知道为什么
？God set Paul free from jail.
但神可以让保罗从监牢里面得释放。
God can open the jail doors.
神可以打开监牢的门。
God can give you another job.
神可以给你另外一份工作。
So here's my question.
所以我的问题来了。
What keeps us from this?
那到底是什么阻拦我们来做这件事呢
？From exercising our authority.
来使出我们信徒的权柄呢
？Because there's something scary about not exercising our authority.
因为你如果不使用这个权柄，就有个
People are made captive.
你若不做，就有事情来了，因为人会受，因为这样受辖制。
I'm thankful for my salvation.
我非常感谢神，因我的救赎。
But I am burdened with a pain for others.
但是我还含着对其他人传福音的负担。
Because they're still enslaved.
因为他们还是一直被奴役着。
I'm literally.Shared the gospel in my class.
我就在我的课堂里面来分享福音。
Perfectly within the realm of what I was allowed to do.
就像我现在做的事情一样。
And I almost got fired for it.
我几乎要被炒鱿鱼了。
But I didn't care.
但是我不在乎。
I knew God would provide.
我知道神会供给。
I knew He fought for me.
我知道神为我想好。
I didn't have to fight for myself.
我必须要为我自己征战。
And so the question is,
所以问题就是,
what can we do?
我们能做什么呢?
What has he commanded?
那神已经命令了我们做什么呢?
First Corinthians,
哥林多前书,
15,
第十五章,
55 through 57.
五十五到五十七节。
And that says, death, where is your victory? Death, where is your sting? Now the sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through the Lord Jesus Christ. Period.
So 第五十五节，死啊，你得胜的权势在哪里？死啊，你的毒钩在哪里？死的毒钩就是罪。罪的权势就是律法。
So because Christ has defeated sin,
因为基督已经打败了罪，
He's given us the authority,
他给我们权柄，
to preach and proclaim forgiveness,
来讲到这个饶恕的部分。
Let's go to John 20.
我们去约翰福音第二十章。
21.
二十一节。
Through 23.
到二十三节。二十章。
Jesus said to them again, "Peace to you. As the Father has sent me, I also send you." After saying this, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit.If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." You have the authority in Jesus to forgive people and proclaim that, the forgiveness of their sins through Jesus.
第二十一节，耶稣又对他们说，愿你们平安，父怎么差遣了我，我也照样差遣你们。说了这话，就向他们吹一口气，说：“你们受圣灵，你们赦免谁的罪，谁的罪就得赦免了；你们留下谁的罪，谁的罪就留下。”
So I'll say, so you have the authority in God.
所以你在神神里面有权柄。
To proclaim forgiveness.
来宣告饶恕。
Now Christ also defeated sickness.
那这时候我们讲到基督同时也打败了疾病。
1 Peter 2:24
彼得前书二十四章。
He himself bore our sins in his body on the tree, so that having died to sins, we might live for righteousness. You have been healed by his wounds. Do you know what the word for salvation is?
No,
go ahead. 第二十四节，他被挂在木头上，亲身担当了我们的罪，使我们既然在罪上死，就得以在义上活。因他所受的鞭伤，你们便得了医治。
The word for salvation in Greek.
希腊文的这个救赎。
Yeah, sozo.
叫 sozo.
Salvation, right?
意思就是救赎。
It has three meanings.
有三个意义。
All wrapped into one.
全部包在一个字里。
Forgiveness of sins, you are saved from your sins.
第一个意义是从罪里面被饶恕。
You are healed from your sickness.
在疾病里面得医治。
And you are free from the bondage of death.
你从死亡里面得
the holding of death, death holding you down.
脱离死的权势。
You have eternal life.
就会有永生。
And these are things we have both now.
那这些是我们现在有的。
And in the future.
的未来也会有。
All three of these.
就三个东西。
And as a result.
所以。
We can minister healing.
所以我们可以来服侍这个医治的部分。
Let's go to Luke chapter 9.
到路加福音第九章。
Oh, sorry, Luke chapter 10.
第十章，路加福音第十章。
And 9, verse 9.
第九节。
his disciples were told this: heal the sick who are there and tell them the kingdom of God has come near you.
第九节，他对这个门徒说，要医治那城里的病人，对他们说，神的国临近你们了。
You can minister healing today.
你今天可以医治，要做医治的服事。
We can pray in faith that things change in a person's body.
我们可以在信心里面祷告，那个疾病可以被神改变。
My friend who's coming here in 2 days.
我有个朋友两天后会来这边。
Met a girl in Cincinnati, USA.
在他在俄亥俄州的辛辛那提遇到的女孩。
She had this part of her hand cut off.
她手掌的部分被砍断。
But reattached.
但是又有接回去。
They had X-rays.
那有一个 X 光的一个照片。
The nerves weren't the nerves were dead.
他的神经已经死了，没办法接回去。
She couldn't move these fingers.
他没有办法动那些手指头。
Couldn't feel all the way down past her elbow.
他是感觉不到东西。
All my friend did was walk right up to this girl.
我的朋友就只是走到那边对他说。
And say in the name of Jesus.
奉耶稣的名。
You are healed.
你得医治了。
He touched her hand.
然后就摸他的手。
And she jumped out of her chair.
然后他就从椅子上跳下来。
She felt his fingers.
她感觉到她的手指。
She couldn't move her hand yet.
她也不能动她的手。
She did not have feeling for eight years.
但是她之前十年没有感觉到任何东西。
He prayed for her again. He prayed again.
她就再祷告一次。
Be healed in the name of Jesus.
奉耶稣的名得医治。
And her fingers started to twitch.
然后她的手指就开始可以动。
He prayed again. Be healed in the name of Jesus.
她就再奉耶稣名再祷告医治她。
Full movement.
他的手就回到完全健康的状态，到后面都有感觉。
God done just like that.
就是马上就得医治。
He's coming. I prayed. I prayed for a woman in Pakistan.
我为巴基斯坦的妇女来祷告。
She had a migraine, switching from spot to spot.
她有偏头痛。
And I just prayed in the name of Jesus, be healed of those migraines.
那我就是奉耶稣的名来医治她的偏头痛。
And they left her immediately.
然后那个头痛就没有了。
Now there's another time.
那还另外的时候
where I prayed for a guy in a wheelchair. I prayed for somebody in a wheelchair.
我也在轮椅上的一个人祷告。
And nothing happened.
没有事情发生。
Did that stop me from praying later?
那有那样阻止我等一下再继续为别人祷告吗？并没有。
Because I'm going to declare healing to every last sick person, period.
因为我会一直不断的对病人宣告疾病，一直到最后的时候。
And nothing is going to stop me.
那没有任何事情可以阻拦我。
And nothing should stop you.
也不应该任何事情可以阻拦我。
Because your heart,
因为你的心
will be filled,
会被充满
with joy,
会被喜悦来充满。
When you see God's kingdom at work,
当你看到神的国度在运行的时候。
The last, sorry, I take a quick drink here.Do a little jig for you. I used to be in theater, so you know.
我以前在戏剧界，所以通常会这样动。
Jesus also defeated the enemy.
所以耶稣也击败了敌人。
Colossians 2:15.
加拉太书的哥罗西书的第十五章。
2:15.
2:15,
sorry. This is Jesus. He disarmed the rulers and authorities and disgraced them publicly. He triumphed over them by him.
第十五节，即将一切执政的、掌权的掳来，明显给众人看，就仗着十字架夸胜。
The enemy is already defeated.
所以其实敌人已经被打败了。
I'm going to tell you, if you have fear,
但是你若有恐惧
that overpowers you,
我在主导你
it's not legal,
那就不是合法的
if you have sadness,
如果你心里有忧伤
that overpowers you,
在主导你
the enemy has no right,
这个敌人是没有任何权利的
he's been defeated,
他已经被打败
the only reason he's still doing that stuff,
唯一的原因他还在做这件事情
is because we haven't declared it,
就是因为我们还没有宣告
we haven't declared victory,
我们还没有宣告胜利。
In the land of your heart,
在你的心的这块土地。
And so tonight,
所以今晚
we're going to do these three things.
我们要做三件事情。
We are going to declare.
我们来宣告。
If you're dealing with guilt or shame,
如果你心里面有任何的罪恶感或者羞耻感
or condemnation,
或者是被定罪
we're going to declare you free.
我们要把你宣告到这个完全
If you're dealing with health issues,
if you're health issues,
We're going to declare you free.
我们要宣告你的释放。
If you're dealing with depression,
如果你有忧郁的情绪
fear,
恐惧
anxiety,
焦虑
worry,
担心
or anything bad like that,
任何不好的东西
we're going to declare you free.
我们也要今天宣告的释放。
And we're all going to join in.
我们全部要在一起。
Now there are two other things we can do.
有另外两件事情我们可以做的。
One of them is we can bring God's will to earth.
第一个我们是可以把神的水体带到地上来。
His kingdom,
他的神国
reigns in your heart.
在你心里中升起。
And it will go forward.
然后继续往前走。
And also,
而且
defeat the power of death.
打败死亡的权势。
So we can say now.
所以我们现在就可以说
that we have eternal life.
我们有永生的生命。
So what I want you to do is I want to just get a quick show of hands here.
所以我现在要很快的讲一下。
Anyone dealing, I don't make anyone feel uncomfortable.
有没有人觉得不舒服去？
没有，要让大家不舒服。
But I just need to kind of know so we can make sure you feel paired up. Is that okay? Is anyone dealing with any form of just guilt or anything like that?
这里弟兄姐妹有没有任何人在你心里面有任何的罪恶感
？Needs forgiveness of any kind.
需要饶恕的。
Make sure you pair up with someone.
那你可能需要找一个搭档。
If you need healing, anyone need healing?
如果你需要医治的。
Okay, we've got 1, 2, 3 couple people here. Perfect. We're going to make sure we get all of you guys as well.
我们当然要为你们祷告。
Okay. And is anybody specifically dealing? We have people dealing with fear or anxiety. Anybody dealing with anything, depression, anything like that, mental struggles.
有没有任何有恐惧、焦虑、忧郁的挣扎的
？Okay. So here's what we're gonna do.
谢谢哈。
All right, I want to make sure we get everybody paired up. So first, forgiveness issues.
Okay, 等下我们要一人两个人有一组。第一个，我们讲到需要祷告、饶恕的部分。
Does anybody need to experience forgiveness?
有没有人需要经历这个饶恕的部分？
So what I want to do is I want to start pairing people. Who would like to pray? You say yes. Yeah, you have to pray for people, yeah. Okay, good. You'll be on. All right, real quick. Who needs the healing? Sorry.
So 谁需要医治？这里下面是谁需要医治的
Okay, so I want to get people praying. Can you two pray for her? And I'm going to come and pray for her.
So you
need
to pray for her. All
right, you need healing as well. Who would like to pray?
谁需要祷告
All right.Would you two like to pray for her? Who else? You, I'm going to come pray for you, but maybe...
所以对面两位为她祷告。
Who else needed healing specifically?
谁还需要医治？
I'm going to come pray for you as well.
那我会也为你祷告。
You guys pray for her.
那这边的为她祷告。
You three maybe praying for her, is that?
那那边的为她祷告。
And I'm going to come pray for you too, don't worry.
那我是也会为她祷告。
Okay. Now, anybody who's not already being prayed, so we're going to do this one first. So first we're going to do healing.
所以第一个我们来做医治的祷告。
I'm going to come around to every single person and declare healing as well.
那我会来到每个人面前来宣告医治。
But I want you guys to prepare the ground.
但是我要你们先做预备。
Okay. So here's what you do.
所以你要这么做。
First, you ask for faith.
所以你第一个你跟谁要信心。
To declare healing.
来宣告医治。
Then you pray and declare it.
然后你就祷告宣告。
The Spirit will give you the words.
圣灵会给你话讲。
Now, here's the key.
你现在的关键。
I've seen healing that's happened instantaneously.
我有看到医治马上就来到了。
And I've seen that happens over time.
看到有时候是
需要时间。 需要时间，对。
Don't be discouraged.
你不要觉得沮丧。
Because I prayed for a guy in Charlotte.
因为我之前在 Charlotte 为一个人祷告。
Who had cancer?
他有癌症。
Like stage, I think it was stage 3 or stage 4.
大概第三或第四期。
And I didn't see him get healed immediately.
我当场没有看他马上得到医治。
But I stood in faith and I said, No, you are healed.
但是我依然以信心宣告，你已经得医治了。
And he affirmed it.
那还确认了。
One month later.
一个月后呢
I went back,
我就回去
and he was fine.
他已经得医治了
okay, this happened again.
所以这种事情会再发生
I prayed for one of my dear friends back in November.
我在十一月的时候为一个朋友祷告
and she was getting, and she just kept getting worse even after I prayed.
即使他在我在为他祷告之后他其实状况是越来越糟的
but she stood in her healing.
他依然在他的医治当中站立
and for the first time,
第一次
in weeks,
是好几周
she can eat,
她吃
she can sleep,
她可以睡
she can drink,
她可以喝
she can walk,
她可以走
and they said she was going to be dead in 2 months.
那其实那时候就说她两个月之后就要死了
So are we all clear?
所以我们就清楚吗
Tonight, God's healing is here.
今天晚上神的医治就在这里
I'm going to come around to everyone and stand with every single person who raised their hand. So I want you to get in groups.
所以现在我们两个两个一组
and that way I'll know where to come.
那我待会儿就会来也为大家祷告
and go ahead and explain what's going on yeah, explain to the other people in the group like what the problem is
okay, 然后你就跟你的搭档讲你的状况
start praying
然后开始为他祷告
and I'll make my way around
然后你就会来
Chris, not just 2x2, just we can get in
small groups, yeah.
Small, yeah, 其实不一定要两个两个大。我们刚刚其实大概已经用牧师大概分了一下组，那我们按照这个组来进行。